But another women's singles for Denmark, and on screen you could see Thea MADSEN. And for Japan, Sayaka SATO, who's looked very good in her first round victory over experienced Bulgarian Petya Nedelcheva in two games, 12 and 13, I think the score was. So in just one match, Sayaka SATO has become one of the favorites to lift this title here at the Emirates Arena. You can see the schedule that's gone before and the results. You can pick out your favorites there and see how they've done. This is the fourth match. And certainly, Thea MADSEN, the young Dane, one of this crop of young Danish women's singles players, all bunched together in the world ranking and coming through. And she had that remarkable result in April back in Kazan in Russia, where she was runner-up in the European Senior Individual Championships to Carolina Marin, of course, the Spaniard, who then went on to win in the World Championships. As always, Mark Phelan, I'm here with you for the duration of the day's play. And it's Sato to serve to MADSEN. Thea herself was taken to three games against English girl Chloe Birch. Took a little time to settle into the match. Anna, I know, likes the tighter, more condensed arenas, sometimes struggle with these bigger arenas. Diminutive figure sometimes doesn't have the power to punch through the drift and to deal with the conditions. I know she'll be coming to the Irish International in 2 weeks. A small, tight hall, and loves to play in that hole, she told me last night. Very quickly, a string gone for MADSEN. You can see it. It'll be a change of weapon for the young Dane. I assume that Kirsty Gilmour is somewhere in the arena watching this match, because she will be scheduled to more than likely meet the winner of this at semi-final stage. Kirsty, easy win against Susanna Pavlikova of Czech Republic, 10 and 11 earlier. She'll now play Eleanor Witt of Sweden in the later quarterfinal. And MADSEN and Sato are fighting it out for the privilege of playing the winner of Karen Schnaza or Chang Ya Lan. And that match currently going on the end court here of five at the Emirates Arena.
Serves over, 3-2.
MADSEN, as I said, runner-up in the European Championships. And that really one of the best results for her this year. At a semi-final at the Czech International back in September. And before that, runner-up at the Portuguese International Championships. And this time last year, quarter-final at the Welsh International and a semi-final at the Irish. When all those results combine to take Thea MADSEN to world number 40 position. Sato, just a few places behind MADSEN at 43 in the world ranking list, but a lot fewer tournaments played. Only 9 tournaments played, of course, for Sato, and 10 tournaments determine your world ranking, so every tournament she's played is counted already towards her world ranking. Best result for her. She had two runners-up positions at the Korean Grand Prix and the USA International Challenge semi-finals at the Sydney International and the Brazil Grand Prix back in the summer, and a semi-final also at her home Osaka International Challenge. And again, in the nine tournaments she's played, it's been very consistent. Worst match, worst tournament was the Chinese Taipei Open, where she was beaten at the round of 32. But other than that, it's been a quarter final or better for Sato. Contrast in styles, contrast in physical demeanor between the two. The light frame of Madsen, and you can see the power in the legs of Sato. And for anyone who's watched the previous match in the women's singles, you can clearly see the difference in quality, the difference in speed already in this women's singles to that of the one that's gone before. Technique and wrist digging the shuttle off the floor by Sato. And Anna Thea sticking in the rally and the smash down the line for the winner. Strong defense from the Dane, and then the audacity to play the cross net off the floor for the winner. Madsen watching that one the whole way as it drifted over the baseline. Sato punching that one into the wind and still failing to find the court. Again, the athleticism of Madsen. That's a poor shot from Anna Thea. Very loose drop. And as always, the humble Japanese reversing off the court, bowing as they leave. There's the interval 3-point advantage for Sayaka Sato over the European vice champion Anna Thea Madsen. Sato here on her own, flying solo. In contrast, on the other side of the net, we get the world famous Kenneth Jonasson issuing the orders and the words of advice to Anna Thea Madsen. Super cross net off the floor for Anna Thea, and then letting herself down with that jumped, lazy clip cross court, almost failing to even reach the net. Nice aggressive punch clear from the Dane, and then letting herself down with that cut down the line. Two poor points in a row from the Dane. Beautiful net control from Sato. You could see the spin on the shuttle as it tumbled over the net. Kenneth Jonasson behind, as always, looking very relaxed. And the loopy drop from Sato. Just catching Madsen unawares. You'll see it here. And then the lift way too long over the baseline. Of course, the any win at the raise in the hall, it's in the back of Thea MADSEN. Oh, that one just clipped the line.
Serves over, 9, 15.
You see it in the replay. Yeah, I think the cork just clipping the line. Good call again from the line judge. Sato not so convinced. And again, Anathea struggling to control her length. No argument this time from the Japanese. Once again, Madsen finding the line. Yeah, right on the line.
11, 60.
Yes! Four good points from the Dane. Battling away. That certainly looked to be going out. Oh, complete misjudgment. And again, the drift just coming in from that side.
16.
And as it left the racket of Madsen, Sato felt it was going to drift out, but then the wind just holding it in. And there's that cross net again off the floor from Anathea. And the flying smash from the Dane. Oh, and the soft little net. Anathea was moving away from the shuttle as she played it. Never a good thing when you're trying to play those net shots. Again, poor control of the shuttle. A convincing 6-point lead now for Sato. Better rally that time from Anathea, finishing it off with a smash down the line.
Close over, 13, 18.
The first 14, very 18. Poor error from the Japanese. Open court. All she had to do was really blow the shuttle into the court for the winner. Pushed it over the baseline. Reprise, really, from Madsen, and this time no mistake from Sato.
Serves over, 19-14.
Scottish Open, in the last couple of years, traditionally, has been a breeding ground for some of the Japanese stars. I remember 2 years ago, Sayaka Takahashi coming here as a relative unknown. And winning, and now going on to be inside, I think, the world's top 12. back to the game in hand. It's game point for Sayaka Sato. And the poor end of that game for Thea MADSEN. Sato pretty much in control from the start. MADSEN did manage to level it up on two occasions, but that was very early on, a 2-all and 3-all, and got back within one. I'm trailing 9-8, but then it was all Sato as she went on a 6-point spree, stretching it out to 15-8. And while there were glimpses of top class play from MADSEN, it was really well controlled, and 3 points in a row at the end. 21-14 victory. And Sato certainly continuing from where she left off yesterday against Petya Nedelcheva. And Kenneth Jonasson, again, a lot of work to do with Anathea. But as always, the calm demeanor of Jonasson never panics, but you can see getting his point across to Anathea, taking his full allocation of time. Sato already on her feet, back in court, shuttle in hand, ready to go. So 13 minutes gone, second game underway. High serve from Sato. Sliced cross court. MADSEN starting to move the Japanese to all four corners. And a poor error at the net. And for the first time in this match, Anathea MADSEN just gets her nose in front. Beautiful technique cross court from the Dane. But certainly, Sato will not be happy with the execution. Just a poor mistake. Yeah. Three-quarter smash down the line. You can see it in slow-mo replay. Plum on the line. Oh, beautiful pickup off the floor from Sato. Beautiful technique, good wrist, floating the shuttle cross court for the winner at the net. Sato thinking twice about playing it. In the end, right decision, letting the shuttle drift out. Two seed Beatrice Corrales, just victorious on the adjoining court. Took 3 games to see off the threat of German Fabienne Depre. I love that shot of MADSEN. Well disguised, that punch clear beautiful attacking shot, really setting up the opportunity in the rally. And a really good opportunity for Anna Thea to play that shot back into the wind. And finishing it off with the cross-court smash. Oh. Frustration from the Dane. She knows that she should have put that one away. Grimace from Kenneth Jonasson in the chair. In a full stretch on the backhand side. And then another error, silly error really from Anna Thea. Sitting here on the concourse level above the courts and the last couple of minutes all of a sudden feeling this very large breeze coming through the hall. And it's sure to affect the players on court also. Some pretty large doors open somewhere.
11-3, interval.
But no mistake from Sato, and you can see as Sato leaves the court, turns and bows. The humility of the Japanese and 11-3 interval lead and a 21-14 win in the first. Under her belt. And yesterday I was asked on Twitter, and if you want to join us and ask a question on Twitter, use the hashtag SOGP. You'll see it just popping up on your screen. And I was asked yesterday for my tips for the women's singles, and certainly one of my tips will be this young lady from Japan, Sayaka Sato. And that's not good news from a Scottish perspective, as she's on the same side of the draw as top seed Kirsty Gilmour, and they're scheduled to meet, I think, at semi-final level.
11-3.
So we're back, and these must-win points now for Anna Thea MADSEN, and that's a good start after the interval for the Dane. Into the net for the kill. I think Anna Thea certainly could have left that lift drift out. Oh, and that one coming back in on the wind for sure. I'm sitting right on that line, and you could see the shuttle outside the line drifting back in. A lot of wind in the hall right now. TV crews coming in for the weekend, and obviously a lot of major exits are open to facilitate them bringing in equipment. And right now, and for the last 20 minutes, there's a serious breeze in the hall. And certainly on that last one, the shuttle outside the line, and the wind taking it back in. Anna Thea, not the most powerful girl on the circuit, but certainly a lot of venom in that smash down the forehand side of Sato. Beautiful net from the Japanese. Was always heading out, and then that side, the wind would have helped it drift even further out. Poor shot from Thea MADSEN. Again, MADSEN at full stretch, but it looked to me that that shuttle may have been drifting out, and that's twice down that side she's taken the shuttle when she clearly could have left it drift out. Full pirouette. Oh, what a shot from MADSEN. The backhand side.
15-6.
But SATO, awake and alive to the threat of the Dane, and really forcing Anathea to change direction. This time, the right decision from MADSEN.
Serves over 16-8.
25 minutes gone. And SATO looking extremely comfortable in this women's singles. Again. Down that line, you can see the shuttle trying its best to come back in on the wind. Weak execution on that round the head cross court from Anathea. You can hear the shuttle clearly coming off the frame of the racket. 18-8. Just a matter of when and not if now for SATO. The Japanese uber comfortable on court. And in 26 minutes, it's match point for Sayaka SATO. And a cross court clip left drift out. And in 26 minutes, as I said, an easy win for what is probably now the tournament favourite, Sayaka SATO from Japan, beating the European runner-up, Thea MADSEN, making Thea look pretty average in that game, it must be said. It pains me to say that. Lovely player, lovely person on court, lovely demeanour and lovely manner. But Sayaka just too good on this occasion. And you can see the disappointment on the face of MADSEN as she leaves the court, shakes the hand of her opponent. But it's SATO who moves forward and gets ever closer to that anticipated matchup with Kirsty Gilmour. Two sets, as I said, 21-14, 21-8, excuse me, as we pan out and have a quick look at the results that have gone before. Middelheiser and Fontaine, Zachiri and Jacques Aol victorious, and Sayaka SATO in two over Thea MADSEN. We'll take a short break, and then we'll be back with the next match on court, which will be men's doubles, featuring from Scotland, Josh Neal and Ben Torrance against Laurent Constantine and Matthew Lolling-Ping of France.